I'm Dr. Balram Bhargava. I'm a professor of cardiology at All India Institute of Medical Sciences at New Delhi. And I have been helping run the Stanford-India Biodesign program for the last 7 odd years. The Stanford-India Biodesign program is a program which is a collaboration between Stanford University, IIT Delhi, and the All India Institute of Medical Sciences. This program had a vision to create the next generation of medtech innovators in India, to innovate low-cost medical devices for India, which would ultimately be useful for the global market. Innovation in India is very much in its infancy, but it is very positive, and I think the opportunity is immense, and a lot of innovation can be done in India, there are issues in terms of advanced technology development, which is a problem to when you get into complicated electronics and sensors and electricals, then we're not the best. But in terms of the clinical needs, finding those needs and sorting out those needs and coming up with solutions, the simple mechanical solutions is easier done, but when it comes to complicated technology, then we are still not there. What India needs most from aspiring innovators is that, first of all, they need to be socially committed. And there is a large population in the country which needs low-cost, affordable medical technologies. And therefore, these innovators have to be very, very socially committed. And if they can innovate low-cost, affordable devices, then it's a win-win situation, not only for the patients, but for the innovators, because the market size is huge. And whatever they innovate at low cost or affordable will ultimately be useful in the Western populations as well, because of Obamacare and the NHS cutting costs, and so it's going to be useful globally as well. The important lessons that have emerged are that first of all, it is very different from innovation in the West. You have to be a part of the system. You have to, the country is very diverse, north versus south, east versus west. There is a different social structures that are there in India. So the innovators have to really identify themselves with the masses to really do the need finding. They need to understand the culture. They need to understand the sensitivities. And that is when they can innovate or come up with the needs. In terms of development of their innovations, there are lots of limitations in terms of difficulties in doing animal studies. So we have to bypass them by doing cadaveric studies. There are advantages of finding people who will be able to help out and they're available more easily than in the West to find people to help out furthering their innovations. In terms of getting grants, venture really don't exist in India in a big way, but the government is funding and the government does support the initial funding for developing their innovations. International grants are available, and India is becoming far more and more competitive for these international grants for innovations. Innovators who are planning to innovate for India should go by the motto that they have to develop a product which is with the vision that it should be more for less for more. So that would be the bottom line. You have to innovate more for less for more.